This program was made possible by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, the John D. and Catherine T. MacArthur Foundation, and additional support from Latino Public Broadcasting, National Endowment for the Arts, National Asian American Telecommunications Association, and others. A complete list is available from PBS. And contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
Best I can do is give you a contract for you to take home and a letter. Again, 8 absence is the rule.
Let's go, students. Your teachers will not have mercy on you.
Today we have an assembly which is called Music in Motion, pretty similar to Starlight Express. We're supposed to have celebs, and I don't know who it's going to be because it changes every time I talk to the producer. It's going to be Paula Abdul, it's going to be Magic Johnson, Kobe Bryant, and Shaquille O'Neal. So some of these have changed.
I understand it will be Todd Bridges, who used to be on the sitcom Different Strokes.
Last week we had the original, Dr. Henry Heimlich, and I was excited about that. And when they told me he was 80 years old and still going around lecturing and so forth and so on, I was even more ecstatic about having him come to Fairfax and preview or premiere his new video titled Don't Choke.
What's up, Fairfax?
Extremely controversial.
My mother raised me very strictly, like her mother did. Whenever I broke her rules, she would punish me. But sometimes I felt she beat me instead of disciplining me.
I told Elizabeth, you know, listen, you can't do that topic.
It's the same topic that I started with, like discipline, but then I picked a particular part of it, and it was shame.
You've got a top level speech.
The 10th award to be announced is speech. The second place winners and recipients of the silver medals for speech are
Elizabeth O.
To be over. I don't want decathlon to be over. I'm gonna miss everyone, and it's my senior year, and the end of the year is coming, and I don't want it to end. I don't want it to end.
I'm getting ready to go to close up, and I am going to be the camera woman. Oops.
See, this is gonna be me now.
Oh, here.
I'm going to Washington, D.C. for close-up with Fairfax High School, and Helen's with me. We're going to learn about our government, and hopefully it'll be fun.
I'm kind of scared or nervous.
Are you scared and nervous?
I know. Just, I guess, meeting new people.
Some people said, oh, that it's, like, really cool that me and her are friends. I'm like, what are you talking about? She goes, and I go, I asked, is it because of our personalities, because we're so different? She goes, yeah. And then plus the fact that you happen to be black and I happen to be Asian, and then we get along so well. And then, I don't know, when she said that, it seemed strange to me. I'm like, why wouldn't we get along? I see Elizabeth. That's all I see.
Bye, Mama. Bye.
Hi.
Helen.
Hi.
Well, this is me talking, Elizabeth, and what you see is what I see, and this is my view. Elizabeth is having a great time.
You're in this new city you've never been in, and it's just like independence, and but you find your own way around. It was fun, you know?
Close-up isn't about us. It's about all of you guys. All of you guys sharing your opinions with each other.
We had this group session, and Helen and I entered late, right? And so
we're always late for everything.
Yeah. So we enter the room, right? And there's no more chairs. So Helen and I, we sit in the middle of the
smack dab
in the mush pot. And the thing is, what we noticed was,
the first thing I noticed that they were all white.
Well, see, I didn't notice that until I did everyone's names, right? And I was thinking, you know, this is close up. It should be diverse and culturally diverse because this is America.
Basically, what goes down to is we're the only minority school here.
I'm at the Korean War Veterans Memorial. I mean, my mom told me about the Korean War, but it seems like every time she tells me, I'm listening, but then I forget. And in a way, I don't want to listen to it. I don't know why. Hi, Helen.
Hey.
How's the weather compared to Cali?
It's cold.
Helen, look at this. Do you see it? White, colored. I wonder where I would fit in. Where would I fit in, Helen?
Today? Neither.
Where would I have fit in back then?
Back then? I don't know.
I was sitting on the bus, and Angie and Michelle, our friends,
mm-hmm.
they were right behind us, and they were asleep. And I turned around to check on them, and I noticed a girl right behind Angie. She was looking over like this, and she was pointing her finger,
yeah.
And she goes, "You suck," and that's how she said it. And she with the ugly look and everything, and I'm like, I couldn't believe it. And then she didn't just stop there. I'm telling you, she didn't just stop there. She looks at Angie, and then she goes, "Ghetto slut."
I just got back from the Holocaust Museum.
They give us this like passport kind of, and you would kind of be that person, or you would travel along with them. And my person, she died in the gas chamber at age 67. And so by the end of the whole thing, you're just like, oh my gosh, you know? And the thing is, it's a true story, you know?
It was a good experience, and I wish I could do it all over again. It's fun traveling with Helen.
I like it. It's tall, it's dark, and it's handsome.
No, wait, you're not talking about the tree, are you?
Yes, I am.
No, the man does this. This is a man thing.
Well, we don't have no man, Mom.
I know.
Oh my gosh, I got so pissed yesterday. I was just like, no. Especially my dad, he's all bitching and he's just like, I was like, how the hell are you gonna get in my life when you're not even around?
One of us has to be strict and one of us has to be soft. That way there is somebody always to be afraid of, and there's somebody to go to.
They don't talk that much, you know, only me and him. Because as much as possible. The only time he talked when he made a lot of mistakes. Then they talk.
My father was like that, and I learned from him. He has a big high grades on nightclubs, on telephone.
Yeah.
Very high grade, actually it's very high.
Payment for me, my telephone bills.
I could care less. I told him I don't want him in my life, and It's I don't know, what is he doing now? I mean, come on. I think it's a little too late to be trying to bond.
My mother's name is Rebecca, actually it's Reverend Rebecca Verstraten McSparren, very long name.
Thank you for joining us on this lovely, very lightly rainy day. It feels fresh and cleansing, and so too, I hope this morning you feel freshened and renewed.
My father's name is David McSparren, or stage name Dave Raven. He plays drums. He also sings with his own band called the Mojo Monkeys. He writes and produces most of their stuff. I love my parents both very much, and my mother knows everything about me. Don't lie to her when it's not necessary. You know, I have a little white lies here and there. Did you do my work? Oh, yeah, sure, Mom. Uh-huh, did my homework.
Jacqueline, we need to get you up, and you need to do a portfolio thing. Take your photos, take your blue papers, and take them down to the dining room. I get exhausted when I walk in here.
My mother is... I don't know where I would be in the world today without her.
What'd I do wrong here?
Well, nothing can
be identified as
a major.
That's who I want.
Architect, Tax Reform Act, 1986.
Football is my heart or whatever. And I wouldn't do anything to play, but if push came to shove, I'd do pretty much anything.
Hey, so Coach Cox couldn't get you into anywhere?
You for real?
Not even partial?
You for real, dude?
Colleges pretty much got the players they wanted already, and it's like, I haven't been offered a deal yet.
Hold on. I don't know what it is. I guess they don't know talent when they see it.
They saying my grades are good, but my SAT score is not up to par. I just knew for sure that I'll make it like to the next level each time. From Pop Warner to high school to college, probably most likely to the pros or whatever. I never thought that my SAT would hold me back. I had my whole mind set on playing football. Now it's like my dreams are fading away or whatever. I guess I'll get back at the camera later.
She could, you know, make up a story and make up a poem that would just shock me. And then she'd go turn around and create and build something. And you'd go, wow, how did you do that? And then she'd come to you and she'd say, put out your hand. And I'd put out my hand. She said, now feel. I go, yeah, it's 2 pennies. And I go, yeah, so? She will feel. One's lighter than the other. She's 4. And I'm going, 2 pennies. And I looked at it and one was a wheat penny. I'm like 1919. She could tell the different weight in a penny.
When I was in fourth grade, like all... Going up to them, I had always had a hard time in school. It was a lot slower than everybody else.
I couldn't get her to school anymore. She would scream so loudly. I couldn't get her into the car. I couldn't get her dressed.
I was just so slow. I felt like I was stupid.
And it just broke my heart one day when she came in and she said,
I just want to die. I don't want to live anymore. I just want to die.
Oh my gosh, she's a fourth grader. You know, it was just awful.
Finally, my mom just took me to the doctor, and I don't know how we came about, but came up with that I had ADD.
And I didn't have enough money to take her through the psychiatry thing and all the testing and stuff. And I said, look, couldn't we just try some Ritalin? Because it really helped my husband.
And within a week, I was shot from the bottom of the class to the top of the class. And Ritalin just, it made me so much happier of a girl. I was so happy.
Ritalin serves to kind of filter things, you know, and help you isolate whatever the task is at hand.
But it's not good to take on a daily basis, especially for kids. Like, take every day, you know, 2 times a day, because it destroys your emotional system, or it has different effects on the kids. And for me, I got so angry. Rather than being depressed, I got angry. I wasn't going to share this because it's like, you know, my biggest regret in my life ever doing, the worst thing I've ever done. And I was so angry at a point where my mom, we got in some stupid argument over doing dishes. And I wouldn't do them. And then my mom kicked me out of the kitchen, but I wanted to be in the kitchen so I could do them or something like that. But she wouldn't let me, and she locked me in my room. And And so I crawled out of my window and I held a knife up to my mom. I didn't touch her with it. And I didn't have any intentions of hurting her. But I was just like, you let me do these dishes. And my mom was like, and it freaks me out today that I actually did that. My mother's the most important thing to me in the world. And I would never want to hurt her.
This whole thing with ADD is an odd thing because I guess there are tests, and but there's so many variations on how people behave and how their brains work.
This is my sister. I love her so much.
But they all have ADD? Do they all have it?
Simone doesn't really.
She's on Ritalin every day. She does.
And actually, we're starting to see ADD in you.
No, you don't! Hers is this memory thing.
I don't think Simone has ADD.
Well, the psychiatrist thinks so. So, mine thinks so. And some of her teachers think so.
I think she's...
Well, anyway.
A lot of times, though, people will like be like, yeah, well, every teenager has her.
Oh, my goodness.
No matter what, if you're gay, if you're bi, you're straight, you know, you can do anything. I mean, that's what I want to prove to people, especially my parents, you know? I mean, just because I'm gay doesn't mean that gay people cannot go to military and all that shit.
Too much complaining, too much talk, and not enough action. What did I tell you about the three-strike rule? I wanted to do two-strike, quiet. I wanted to do two-strike. I'm not as lenient as the first sergeant, the cadet. That doesn't take the responsibility is the loser, not me. Why are you in here in the first place? Prepares you for life.
Well, like
okay, wait
said,
till you get your report cards, right? Your progress reports. A lot of you are gonna drop the bomb. This ain't a freebie class. This is a bona fide curriculum that's been in existence since 1918.
So shouldn't we be doing something right now?
And this program will be in existence for the next generation. So you're just a statistic.
I don't know what's wrong with Sergeant Hernandez, but he was just like, I don't know, I think there's something. I think he doesn't like me that much, you know?
What's going on, man? Jet, what's going on with the hairdo?
What's color there?
Christmas tonight.
What do you think of Jet's new hair color?
Parang ano, spoba. It's like a brush.
You know, Pim, ano ni Jet?
It looks like a toothbrush.
I kind of like quit ROTC. I mean, just like okay. That.
We'll do the best we can. If we don't pass, then we'll do better next time.
Is the Army right for me? I mean...
If it's a high-level type inspection...
Is that really what I wanted to do?
It happened to me before.
Okay. He doesn't want to marry me. He says I'm pressuring him. Boo-hoo. Poor baby. When are you going to find a catch like me? Don't slap me.
Don't slap me.
I didn't hurt you. I went like that. And you went like that. You did. Don't slap me. I just went like that to you. God.
Like that?
Yes, like that. Stop!
She's really codependent on you, dude. Like, she's like, you're her, like, you know,
She's your shoulder.
I lent my mom $600. She was upset at me because I lent my mom $600.
He thinks that it should just be his decision to give his mom the money. I don't have a problem with that, but he didn't even talk to me about it, you know? Like, maybe I'm not his wife, whatever, but that's something you discuss.
So then me and
Gorilla Boy. Like, yeah. You guys are stuck, you know, like weekend, school, day.
And she says we don't see
each
other.
And a weekend, and she's not satisfied.
I don't want to have to be made to feel like I'm unimportant.
Can you think of any reason why he wouldn't discuss that with you?
Because I'd probably have a problem with it.
Uh-huh.
But I'd get over it.
It's hard when you love somebody and they hate your family.
I don't hate any of them. I just...
You tell me that all the time. She gets mad because I'm with my family so much.
Yeah, that's why I don't understand about her, you know?
And you know what she gets mad about? Us not being able to sleep in the same room when she sleeps over. Like, how many, parents are cool with, like,
their boyfriend or girlfriend sleeping over.
Yeah, but you come with a like Latin family. You know how.
Yeah, and it's even like it's more, even more. It's even more strict.
Hey, white people mean. I mean, come on.
Yeah, yeah, no, for real.
They don't give a shit, but like Hispanics, like my family, they like talk shit behind other people's backs.
She just needs to work out a lot. She's always.
Yeah, she needs to work on a lot. I'm sick of being the problem, being the loudest, being, you know, the biggest, being just everything, the most.
It's just you have to curb the hostility. That's all. That's all people are reacting to, the anger. And think about what's causing the anger.
I want to say him sitting here, you know, being, saying she needs help. She's got a lot to work on. She pointing the fucking finger.
Sometimes I think this ain't worth it, you know? It's just too much drama. I mean, like, love shouldn't hurt this much.
I changed my life for him. I changed who I was for him. Because I loved him so much. But I guess I didn't love myself enough.
You are completely, blindly, like, ready to move in with me to marry me. And it's a scary thing. I'm not ready.
Because you know you can't hold that you're gonna find somebody else.
No, that's bullshit. Right. That's not what it's about.
And what is it about, babe?
It's about being cautious.
Cautious for what? I never said I wanted to fucking have babies and get married and fuck our future. I said I don't want to have children till I'm like 30. I want to struggle with you. I want to make my life with you. And that's all. I'm not asking for much more of a commitment. Like what we have now, just that we live together. And would it be so bad that we'd be married? I mean, so you wouldn't be living in sin anymore?
This is a scary thing to get married now. I'm 17. You're 17.
Do you think you're gonna find somebody else?
No, I don't. Well, I'm not sure.
Am I not enough for you? Am I too much? I don't know, babe.
It's a scary thing, Maria. I'm not completely ready.
You can't look at me and say I love you enough to be your husband for the rest of your life?
Not yet.
My mom is just like, she's going all out in the house. Trees, everything. Our whole house looks like a damn like light fest or something.
Like ever since we're like putting up the Christmas tree and you know all the Christmas decorations, it's been like acting nice.
Got a pancake?
Well, it's Christmas. Come on, we're gonna have to get along somehow.
Look what I got from Jess.
Wow.
Beautiful. Sure,
please,
sir. I'm actually happy that I'm spending Christmas with my family. I gave my dad like a hug and I kissed him for like the first time in like 2 years. I kissed my dad, especially to my dad. I would just like to take this time to say I'm sorry for I guess all the shit I put you through.
This New Year's means I hope that when we enter this new millennium, we leave the hate, the anger, the terrorism, the racism, and the hunger behind. I mean, more years pass by, the more civilized we should be.
Second year.
And yes, I am in the bathroom because sometimes this is the only place where I can get some privacy. Sorry, but anyways, Happy New Year.
But don't tell my mom because I made her a promise.
Sanjay Clark doesn't age at all, man.
Hope, as you can see, having a great New Year's. It was so much fun.
I went to sleep at about 11 o'clock and I slept through the New Year's.
New Year's isn't anything big.
Not even Millennium New Year?
It's just like any other Millennium.
Kind of happy because me and my dad are like really, really, really getting along well. He smiles at me like, I'm proud of you. And I just hope that it stays this way, hopefully forever.
There's soap in my eyes, but I'm still trying to see some of the life, some of the life, some of the life. Meanwhile, I'm caught between the black and whites in full scholarship penitentiaries, between lives knocked down like bowling.
There's much more of senior year at PBS Online. Hear all the music, talk about this episode, and follow the stories you'll only find online at pbs.org. To order the entire senior year series on video cassette or the companion CD to the series featuring Oso Motley, Ani DeFranco, The Coup, and others, call PBS Home Video at 1-800-PLAY-PBS.
This program was made possible by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, the John D. and Catherine T. MacArthur Foundation, and additional support from Latino Public Broadcasting, National Endowment for the Arts, National Asian American Telecommunications Association, and others. A complete list is available from PBS. And contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
I don't ever want to talk to Boris again, and I'm not joking.
You'll reconcile with him?
No, I think our marriage is through.
Sixth period, they're going to make a PA announcement. We got to go to the principal's office.
And I'm just going to cut through the chase. Cheerleading squad is suspended starting today.
This is PBS.